In this clip, we're going to talk about the proper service procedure to inspect, remove, and replace your steel brake lines and bleed the braking system on a Ford Explorer. In this step, we're going to talk about brake fluid, the different kinds of it, filling our master cylinder, and bleeding the brake system after replacement of our brake lines. This is .3 brake fluid. They have .4 and .5. You're going to want to refer to your owner's manual to see which fluid you're going to want to use. This Ford Explorer takes .3. I'm going to unscrew the master cylinder reservoir cap and fill it up to the full line. You can see it says max there, and the line above it is the indicator mark. I'm going to go ahead and fill it up. I'm going to have my assistant hop in the vehicle, and he's the one that's going to be actuating the brake pedal while we bleed the brakes. All right, I have my assistant in the vehicle and my master cylinder full. What I'm going to do is demonstrate the process for bleeding your brakes. You have to bleed all the air out of the system just due to the fact that air is compressible and brake fluid isn't. If you leave the air in there, you're not going to have any pressure developed. All of your pedal stroke is going to be used to compress the air instead of deliver fluid. So what we're going to do is he's going to apply the pedal down. Go ahead, down. I'm going to crack the bleeder open. There you go. You can see the fluid in the air coming out. I'm going to close it and instruct him to come up. What that does is draw more fluid from the master cylinder instead of drawing air in through the bleeder. Go ahead and go down. Go up. Down. And up. That is the proper technique for bleeding your brakes. You're going to want to start with the wheel that is farthest away from the master cylinder and work in order in ascending order to the closest one.